why do some human groups cooperate while others enter into conflict? The answer is complex, but according to some anthropological theories, it is the tendency to minimize risk that drives the nature of our interactions with others. I use the archaeological record to study ancient hunter-gatherers and search for insights into the evolution of the behaviors that we can observe today. According to observations of modern hunter-gatherers, when a certain food is predictably available in abundant patches, groups will tend to be territorial and hostile to each other to secure exclusive access to the resource in question. That is what happens with good areas for shellfish collection. On the other hand, when a resource is abundant but somewhat unpredictable, people will cooperate and share information to minimize the risk of going hungry on any particular year. That is what happens with herds of migratory herbivores, whose exact location varies between years. I study the morphology and the chemical composition of animals from archaeological sites in Malawi and Zambia, in southern Central Africa. These animals represent the food remains of ancient people, thousands of years ago. This way, I can reconstruct what the past environments were, what people ate, and how their prey moved across the landscape. I analyze how the chemical composition of the enamel changes across the teeth of prey animals, thus tracking changes in environment and diet. If the chemical composition remains stable throughout the tooth, then that particular animal did not experience the seasonal cycle. We know from independent data that rains were seasonal, so that animal must have been migratory and following the rains. If instead the chemical composition does change throughout the tooth, then environment and diet change through time. That was a non-migratory animal that stayed in one place and experienced the seasonal cycle. To local hunters, a migratory animal was available only for part of the year, and its position across the region was poorly predictable. The best way to capture this animal was to cooperate with neighboring groups. The non-migratory animal stayed in the region year-round. Therefore, the most efficient strategy to exploit this resource was to claim exclusive access to this part of the territory. I then repeat this analysis hundreds of times for different animals, different time periods, and different archaeological sites across a large region. This way, I can reconstruct the distribution of animal resources through time and space in the region of interest. I then collaborate with colleagues studying the provenience of other archaeological remains, like personal ornaments and other human-made objects, to achieve a holistic view of people's mobility and subsistence. Understanding what drives the nature of human relationships with neighbors, allies, and competitors is important because it provides a more nuanced view of cooperation and competition and the material basis of these interactions, dispelling the notion that humans are innately hostile to each other.